Anthony Delgado, directly from PR, another fellow New Yorker, you know, doing moves out here. And you already know, it's your boy Joe, back at it again, codingphase.com. Your boy is back and I done did it again. One more time. So, yeah. introduce yourself, Anthony. What's good?
Yo, so what's going on, Coding Phase? What's good? My name is Anthony Delgado. I've been a software developer and serial entrepreneur for the last 10 years. And yeah, man, I'm super humble, super happy to be on the show, bro. When I found your content, I was like, wow, this is like a real New York dude, like a real New York dude that's out here that's talking about code. And like me, like my whole thing is like nerds should be like a like that's a bad stereotype. Like mm-hmm. that should be a racial slur. Like, yeah. You call me a nerd, I want to punch you in the face. So like when I found your content, I was so excited and I'm super excited to be on your show, bro.
Yeah, man, that's one of the things, man, where when I got into this game, you know, nobody was doing this. You know, I'm from the block, you know, it's like, you can't be like, yo, son, I got this new skills, JavaScript, son. And it's like, they're going to be looking at you like, yo, bro, we out to the strip club. I'll see you later. You know what I mean? Like, I ain't trying to hear that, you know. But, yeah, man, straight from New York, you know, that's where I'm from, Queens. You know, what part of New York you're from?
So my family's originally from the Bronx, and then I lived in Westchester, and this is probably the most thugged out story, and that's why I wanted to tell it on your show. So I haven't really told this story publicly before. So basically, I've been coding. I've been doing my thing since I was a little kid. My mom was actually coding, and I grew up in Jersey, right across the water, in West New York, New Jersey, like right across the water. And okay. So my mom was coding in the 80s. I had a computer when I was in second grade. I was like the first kid with the internet. I was making websites when I was a little kid. And then like, obviously, like you said, you're going to the street life. So I was selling drugs. I was selling weed. I was selling sneakers. I was selling t-shirts. I was selling everything to make a buck. And then I tell this story. When I was 16, I used to sell mixtapes and I used to sell them in the street. Mm-hmm. And then when I was 17, 18, I got an Amazon and eBay account. And I went from making $50 a week selling mixtapes to $2,000-$3,000 a day selling mixtapes on eBay and Amazon.
Wow.
And that was back when like the 50 cent shit was popping and you know, the mixtape wave was really heavy. And yeah, I went from like, hey, you want to buy a mixtape in fucking high school to making $3,000 a day on eBay and Amazon selling mixtapes. So I've always used the internet, but I always use it to make money. I never saw myself like a coder or a nerd, JavaScript developer. I didn't even know that shit existed. You know what I mean? Like, and back then, I'm 33. Back then when I was 18, there wasn't even a Google headquarters in New York. Mm-hmm. All that stuff was in California. That stuff wasn't even really out here. So we didn't really have exposure to it. You know what I mean?
Yeah, no, that's like the same thing for me. Like my first website was like at 14. I did like a Dragon Ball Z website, and it was crazy because I had uploaded like all the movies they had. You know, you're a little kid, you don't even know about copyright, no nothing. So I had this my mom bought like this little machine to be able to connect it to the VHS. So I had all the Dragon Ball Z movies. So I copied it, made it into a real player. I don't know if you remember that.
Real player with the little blue logo. Yeah.
So I used the real player to create files and then I put it up online. So that's how you was able to watch video. There was no YouTube back then. We're talking like 99, 2001, around there. Like there was nothing. So I uploaded all these videos and in 1 month I got 500,000 users in there and it was just flooded. I guess every kid in America was like, yo, let me get that Dragon Ball Z, son. So I was hype. I was like, yo, telling my other friends, they're like, yo, I got 500,000 people in here. They're like, man, they don't even care about that, right? Next thing you know, I got a letter from the FBI. They're like, yo, listen, you bro, you know that letter you get from like the ISP? They're like, yo, if you don't cut that shit out, son, you going to jail. And you know, I had just seen that movie, was it Hackers, the movie? Yeah. And you're like, oh man, I don't want to go through that, what that guy went through. So I said, I deleted everything. I got off the internet for like probably to like 2021.
Oh, you just stopped using the internet. You're like, I'm done with the internet.
Yeah, I just stopped doing websites. I was like, yo, I'm getting too crazy with it.
I used to sell Avizu jeans too, but I used to get the bootleg joints in Chinatown, and we used to get them joints for like $10.
23rd Street.
All day, right? I used to run an auction. And then eBay has this thing called Second Chance. And I was Second Chance everybody. Everybody like over like $50 was getting a Second Chance. And And yeah, so I did a lot of eBay and Amazon when I was young. But then I started feeling like I wasn't making money because like I still had to buy stuff. Yeah. You know, and then sometimes you'll buy something and it doesn't sell and you get stuck mm-hmm. with it and all this. And it was like kind of like a rat race. And mm-hmm. then at the same time, I was like, eBay started shutting me down. That's what it was. Mm-hmm. eBay started shutting me down for selling the fake shit, right? And so I was like, fuck eBay. I'm going to make my own website, right? So I made my own website. And then that website started to blow up. And then I made a store in person. Mm-hmm. So I had an in-person store.
Wow.
And I ran that for like a year or two. Business got a little slow. Some dudes actually went in and like burglarized the store when I wasn't there. And mad bullshit happened. I was like, you know what? I'm going to sell the store. So I flipped the store. It was actually a come up for me because I had never sold a business before. I flipped the store and then I was like, all right, I'm going everything online, right? And then at the same time, they sent an undercover police officer into my store mm-hmm. and they had him ask, oh, do you know where I could get some weed? And I gave him one person's phone number. And because of wow. that one person, I got a conspiracy charge.
Wow.
And that conspiracy charge ended up leaving for me to move to New York City because I went on the run. So I moved to New York City.
And don't worry.
I lived in New York City for 5 years, 100% coding. I was learning to code while I was on trial. So when I was on trial, I'm learning to code. And then they're like, all right, you got to go to jail. I was like, do they have computers in jail? Because I'm learning to code right now. Like, I want to keep, like, you got me up. It's fine. Just put me in there with a laptop. Mm-hmm. And they're like, no. So I was like, all right, fuck this. Boom. So I go to New York. And then I was living in New York for 5 years. And I started making money, making websites for people. Like, I can't get a regular job because I don't want the freaking cops to find me.
Yeah.
I'm just going. I used to go to every local business, and I'd just be like, hey, what's up? How you doing? I make websites. I make you a website for $500. Just give me $250 now, $250 when it's done. Mm-hmm. And that's how I started. And I was just going to every local business. Hey, can I make a website? Meanwhile, I got fucking warrants. I used to go to the grocery store. I go to Whole Foods, and I'm laughing. I'm like, I'm free right now. It's lit. Like, they ain't never going to find me. And I was out there. I was in New York City for 5 years. For 5 years, making all my money online. Coding. I had a website called unreleasedhiphop.com.
Nice.
And I used to put all the leaks. When the new Lil Wayne would come out, I would put it on there. The Drake. All that stuff. And I started making money from Google Ads.
Mm-hmm,
I was making at one point like $2,000 to $3,000 a day off of Google Ads. Like that day that the Drake album would drop or the Lil Wayne album would drop, boom, I'm making $3,000 just on that day.
Mm-hmm.
And so whatever, long story short, I did consulting. I worked with this one company called Cranium Fitteds. We built that into a multi-million dollar company. And I'm just making a little website. But all of a sudden that website took off for them. Mm-hmm. And long story short, I ended up throwing a big ass party in my house. The cops came, got raided. I went to jail. So I'm in jail, but the whole time I'm in jail, I'm getting checks from Google.
Wow.
Google AdSense was sending me money the whole bid.
I'm just cashing in. I'm like, yo, I got a bag waiting for me.
Yes.
Wait till I hit the block.
And so I'm hood rich. Everybody's like, oh, what you here for? Like one bag of weed. And motherfuckers is in there for like all sorts of crazy stuff. Oh, attempted murder, burglary, bank robbery, all this crazy stuff. And so, but I'm hood rich. So I'm ordering mad magazines. I'm ordering mad books. I read mad books. Bro, I came out. Motherfuckers like, did you go to college? How did you come out?
Dude is in there like, yo, I got this, son. What up? who won what right here, man? Yo, I'm throwing this. I'm doing a freaking cake right now. We're doing a cake. Dudes start pricking up the chocolate chips. It's like, yo, let's cook. Something up here, son.
Oh man. I feel like you took a vacation or two in your life. But yeah, man. So you know, I did my little bit. It wasn't that bad. It was like 18 months, and then I came out and I was on the bracelet. So I had a freaking bracelet on my ankle, and they were like, get a job or go to jail. And I was like, all right, well, I don't want to go back to jail. That's for sure. I will never, ever let that happen to me ever again. Mm-hmm. And I know I had said I never want to get a job. I'm a lifelong entrepreneur, lifelong hustler. But you know what? It's time to get a job. But I'm not going to go and get a job like all these freaking people in the streets.
Mm-hmm.
I want to make sure that I'm in an office. So I was actually blessed. The one company that I did consulting with, he showed up at the court when they were releasing me, and he showed up in a suit, and he's like, yo, bro, this guy made me millions of dollars. I will hire him the minute he comes out.